Hello, my name is Jason Bolton, and I'm the Food Safety Specialist here at the University of Maine Cooperative Extension.
And I'm Robson Machado, the Food Science Specialist here at UMaine. We all heard that eating more fruits and vegetables is good for us, but with news headlines like 31 people die after eating E. coli contaminated sprouts, or 11 hospitalized after eating salmonella contaminated greens, and many other produce-related outbreaks, one might be concerned when walking the produce aisle. To help with that, we will share some easy steps for washing produce that can reduce your risk of getting a foodborne illness. According to the FDA, washing produce before peeling, cutting, chopping, or using it anyway in prepared food will reduce the number of bacteria that could be present on it, and this will reduce your risk of getting sick. But before we start talking about the proper ways to wash fruits and vegetables, we need to get the basics right. You should wash your hands with warm soapy water for 20 seconds before even touching the food. Don't forget between your fingers and the back of your hand. Also, make sure to wash all the utensils, equipment, and surfaces that you use with that same warm soapy water.
For washing produce, you want to use cool water. Make sure the water is drinkable. Another tip is to look for products that have intact skin that are not bruised when you're at your grocery store or farmer's market. You want to never use detergents to wash your fruits and vegetables. They can leave a residue which is unsafe and not good for you to consume. If you see packages of produce that are labeled as pre-wash, triple wash, or ready to eat, there's no need to rewash these products. Research has shown that rewashing these products does not improve food safety, and in some cases can actually further contaminate already clean products. So for fruits or vegetables that have a thick, tough surface, like potatoes or carrots, you want to make sure that you scrub the outside of them, removing any dirt. For produce with large surface area like greens, such as kale, lettuce, or spinach, or vegetables with lots of nooks and crannies, like broccoli, cauliflower, or things of that nature, you want to make sure you soak them for 1 to 2 minutes in cool water. You can also use a spinner to remove excess water. Just make sure that that spinner is clean and sanitary. Lastly, for delicate and fragile fruits and vegetables like cherries, strawberries, and blueberries, or even raspberries, you want to wash them in cool running water in a colander. Soaking them can cause liquids to leach out of the fruit, leading to damage of the produce. You can dry your produce with a clean paper towel. The friction will help remove bacteria and will also remove moisture. Drier produce will have a longer shelf life in case you plan to store them before you consume them. But ideally, you want to wash your produce directly before you use it. Talking about storage, once you're done washing and preparing your fruits and vegetables, you want to make sure you don't temperature abuse them. This means that you want to refrigerate your produce, bringing the temperature down below 40 degrees and putting them in the fridge. When you peel or cut to expose the interior portions of the fruit or vegetable, it can cause the fruit or vegetable to spoil faster, and this is why we refrigerate them. This is also why you should purchase already cut or peeled produce that is in refrigeration temperature in the grocery store.
Thanks for taking the time and watching this video. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us. Take care and have a good day.